Victims of a bandit attack in Laikipia have been buried with calls on the government to intensify security in the troubled region. The three, Peter Njuguna, Stephen Kariuki and Julius Kiptanui, were killed despite an ongoing operation by the government to smoke out bandits in the restive county.
The victims were killed on October 10th when suspected armed bandits staged a daring attack when they raided Kiambogo village. The bandits had raided a home in the area and made away with 32 herds of cattle and 2 sheep. And as they were driving away, the stolen animals towards Laikipia Nature Conservancy shot dead the three and injured another resident.
Wameenda watoto wake wamewacho bila baba. Mabibi zao wamewacho bila bwana.
Leaders led by TSP party leader Mwangi Kiunjuri, former Mukuroini MP Kabado wa Kabando, Minor Jenga, and a host of local leaders who attended the joint burial ceremony for the three lamented that despite the heavy presence of security forces that include the Rapid Deployment Unit, the General Service Unit, the Anti-Stock Theft Unit and General Duty Officers, cases of insecurity have continued to escalate.
For how long shall our people suffer? For how long shall our children cry and our wives cry? Tunafika mwisho. Matiangi anakuja all the way from Nairobi. The whole security of Kenya inakuja Laikipia. Munakuja munaapa that in 7 days there will be peace in Laikipia. In 7 days, mauaji anaogesa maradufu.
This is not about Laikipia. This is about the nation. Kama hamwezi, kama viongozi, kusponsor motion of adjournment in the National Assembly, kuongea about the insecurity na mauaji ambayo yako hii area, is a failure in leadership.
Kiunjuri said the patience of area leaders and residents has run out and called on the president to personally intervene.
Kama serikali iko na seriousness about Laikipia, lazima kila kijiji kipewe buduki 10 ya police reservist.
Insecurity in the region has led to the destruction of livelihoods and consistent disruption of both economic and learning activities. Caroline Kamara reporting for Lunchtime News.